Hello students, you all know we are doing chapter 2 polynomials of class 10. So far we have discussed the degree of the polynomial, division of polynomial on the basis of degree, zeros of polynomial and geometrical representation of the zeros of the polynomial. Today we will learn very important topic, that is relationship between the zeros and the coefficient. You know, quadratic polynomial general expression is ax square plus bx plus c. Now let alpha and beta are the zeros of this polynomial. So we have the two relationships or the two formulas, that is the sum of the zeros, that is alpha plus beta, it should be equal to minus b upon a. What is b? You can see here it is a coefficient of x, this minus is of the formula. And what is a? It is a coefficient of x square. Similarly, the product of the zeros, that is the product of alpha and beta, is equals to c upon a. What is c? C is a constant term. Again, a is the coefficient of x square. Now, on the basis of these two relations, we will learn these two relations with the help of one example. Suppose, find the zeros of this polynomial and verify the relationship between the zeros and its coefficient. This example is taken from your book NCERT only. So we are provided with this polynomial. See, in the general form of a quadratic polynomial, in the middle we are having the x term. So first of all, we will rearrange the given polynomial. 6x square minus 7x minus 3. Now you all know the splitting, middle term splitting. This we will do, but before that, what is the value of a? 6. What is the value of b? Minus 7. What is the value of c? Minus 3. This is not necessary to write down this, but just because for your clarity, in the rough you can write that. Now we will do the middle term splitting. 6 threes are 18. Now we will divide 18 so that we can get 7. So 9 twos are 18 minus 9x plus 2x will give us minus 7x. From 6x square minus 9x, we will take 3x common. So, when we will divide 3x by 6x square, we will get 2x. When we will divide minus 9x by 3x, we will get 3. From here, we will take 1x common. And when we will divide 2x by 1, we will get 2x. When we will divide minus 3 by 1, we will get minus 3. These two brackets are same. So, taking these 2x common, second bracket will be 3x plus 1. Now from here, comparing these two brackets with zeros, we will get from here x is equals to 3 upon 2 and from here x is equals to minus 1 upon 3. So let these are our two required zeros. So let alpha is equals to 3 upon 2 and beta is equals to minus 1 upon 3. Now we will find the sum of the zeros, that is alpha plus beta. So putting the value of alpha here and putting the value of beta here, we will take the LCM and we have got 7 upon 6. Now this should be equal to minus b upon a. So separately we will calculate minus b upon a. This is the minus of formula. Value of b is minus 7. A is 6. So this is 6. So on comparing equation 1 and 2, what we have seen, sum of the zeros is equals to minus b upon a. This relation is verified. Similarly, we will verify the product relation also. Now we will find the value of alpha into beta, that is 3 upon 2 into minus 1 upon 3. 3, 3 cancel out, we will get minus 1 upon 2. We will name this equation as equation 3. This should be equals to c upon a. Now we will find the value of c upon a, that is minus 3 upon 6. We will reduce it, we will get it minus 1 upon 2. We will name this equation as 4. Again on comparing equation 3 and 4, we can see that they are equal. Therefore, alpha into beta is equals to c upon a. Hope this relationship is very much clear to you. Thank you. Hello students, welcome once again. As you know, we are doing chapter 2 polynomials of class 10. And so far we have covered the degree of polynomials, zeros of polynomials, geometrical representation of zeros of polynomial, relationship between the zeros and its coefficient. Today we are going to learn framing of quadratic polynomial. So it is a formula for framing the quadratic polynomial, that is x square break minus bracket sum of zeros into x plus product of zeros, that is x square, you know, sum of the zeros is alpha plus beta, into x, and product of zeros are alpha into beta. This we have discussed in the previous question, in the previous video. Now we will, on the basis of this, we will do one sample question. Example: if sum of the zeros is 4 and the product of 0 is 1, find the quadratic polynomial. Now according question, sum of the zeros is 4, that is alpha plus beta is 4. Product of the zeros is 1, that is alpha into beta is 1. Using this formula, quadratic polynomial is given by x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha into beta. We will substitute the value of sum and product from here in this equation, that is x square minus 4 into x plus 1. On opening the bracket, we get x square minus 4x plus 1. Hence, x square minus 4x plus 1 is our required quadratic polynomial whose sum of the 0 is 4 and the product of 0 is 1. Hope the concept is clear to you. Thank you and have a great day.